Dawah tips from the Sunnah. In this short video, I'm going to be giving some small examples of ways to give Dawah based on the Sunnah or way of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Dawah basically means invitation. In this context, it refers to inviting people towards Islam. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned, narrate of me even if it was one verse. So it is duty upon Muslims to do this. There's also an increased need for this nowadays, as there's a great misunderstanding regarding Islam, such as how it was spread and the treatment of women in Islam. There's a saying that actions speak louder than words, so perhaps the best way to give any form of Dawah is to learn about the Prophet, peace be upon him, and to try and follow his example in our life. As an example, when Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, was asked about the character of the Prophet, peace be upon him, she mentioned that he was the Quran. When dealing with others, try to smile as the Prophet, peace be upon him, used to smile, and he mentioned that a smile is a charity. Likewise, be honest and deal well with others, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, was known as As-Sadaq al-Amin in pre-Islamic times, which means the honest and trustworthy. Try to help others, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, also used to help others in need, but never do anything purely with the intention of getting some reward or some sort of recognition in return. Be respectful towards other religions and be open towards them, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, was, and people from other religions would often question him, such as Jewish people. As an example, there was a companion of the Prophet, peace be upon him, known as Abdullah ibn Salam, who was a Jewish rabbi but converted to Islam. Do not force people to study about Islam, and if they do not react very positively according to any information you send them, do not get angry with them. Do not overwhelm them with information and remain patient with them. There is no compulsion on religion, and despite all of his efforts, the uncle of the Prophet, peace be upon him, Abu Talib, never accepted Islam. Never give up hope on people and pray for them as well, and in some cases, even if they are against Islam, also pray for them. As an example, the Prophet, peace be upon him, did not give up on others, and he made a supplication that at least one of the Umars should accept Islam. That's Umar ibn Hisham, who was better known as Abu Jahl, or Umar ibn al-Khattab, who were both enemies of Islam. It was in fact Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, who accepted Islam and became one of the greatest Muslims despite wanting to kill the Prophet, peace be upon him, before, and also went on to become the second rightly guided Caliph. When giving Dawah towards others, try to involve your other family members and gain their support as much as possible. If you are married, be sure to involve your wife in the activities, as they can be an incredible blessing, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned four good things in this world, one of which is a righteous wife. As an example, Khadija, may Allah be pleased with her, was the first wife of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and supported him for many years, and was also the first person to accept Islam. Nobody is perfect, so try to work as a team and try to utilize other people's skills and abilities as much as possible. As an example, the Prophet, peace be upon him, was illiterate, but he asked his companions to write things for him, such as the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, which was written by Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him. Try to develop your language skills and learn other languages, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, noticed that his companion, Zayd ibn Thabit, may Allah be pleased with him, had a talent for languages, so he encouraged him to learn the language of the Jews. Use the media that is available. So during the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him, there was no media and people used poetry. So a number of the companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him, wrote poetry, such as Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him. In modern times, you could use other things such as social media, such as Facebook, Twitter, other websites, making videos and other technology. Listen to other people speak and try to understand them, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, used to listen to others when they used to speak to him. Thank you for watching. Please like and share this video and subscribe to my channel.